Hi, this is Kate from MinuteEarth. This is 2,4,6 trinitrotoluene, better known as TNT. This itty-bitty bit of TNT, 7 grams worth, contains enough chemical energy that, when detonated, it could lift a bowling ball about 600 meters into the air. And this is 7 grams of sugary deliciousness, better known as a marshmallow. Its chemical energy could lift that same ball nearly 2,000 meters. Wait, what? If sugary deliciousness can release 3 times more energy than TNT, why doesn't roasting a marshmallow blow your arm off? Luckily for us s'more lovers, the rates at which the energy gets released via chemical reactions are very different. Lots of chemical reactions release energy as atoms rearrange themselves into new substances. The longer it takes for that rearrangement to happen, the more slowly the energy is let loose. Since TNT already has all the atoms it needs to rearrange itself into a bunch of gases and a bit of extra carbon, you just need to add some energy to initiate the reaction, usually with a shock from a detonator, and boom! All that rearrangement happens, and all the energy is unleashed in a few millionths of a second. But the marshmallow is missing an ingredient. It needs to combine with oxygen to form carbon dioxide and water. In other words, to burn. Once you add some energy to get things started, only atoms on the marshmallow's surface, where its sugar meets oxygen from the air, will be able to rearrange themselves. As the marshmallow burns, more and more of its sugar will encounter the oxygen and be able to react. But burning the whole sugary shebang and releasing all its energy will take an entire minute or so. So sure, when you roast, well, burn, a marshmallow, you'll get way more energy than when you detonate an equal mass of TNT. But you'll release all that energy over a much longer time. It's just like how a torrential downpour can be intense, but a gentle rain that lasts for hours can actually dump way more water overall. But sugar doesn't always take its sweet time to unleash its energy. If sugar is ground so finely that it has enough surface area where it can interact with oxygen, and if there's enough energy around to initiate a reaction, it too can release its energy all at once, a la TNT. In 2008, a sugar dust explosion leveled a Georgia sugar refinery and killed 14 people. But why is releasing energy quickly so destructive? Well, when you burn a marshmallow, or even a giant pile of marshmallows, the energy seeps out slowly enough that it can simply dissipate into the environment, like that gentle spring rain, which might fall all day, but so slowly that the soil can soak it up. But there's a limit to how quickly energy or water can get absorbed. When it's released faster than that limit, whatever's left over has to go somewhere. Extra energy ends up as destructive waves of pressure and heat, just like extra water becomes a destructive flash flood. Which, incidentally, is an important thing to watch out for the next time you're roasting a marshmallow. Energy isn't always destructive. It can do good stuff too. And with Tab for a Cause, you can actually do a ton of good with the teensiest bit of energy. Just install the browser extension, and Tab for a Cause will donate money to a charity each time you open a new browser tab. Tab for a Cause just reached an amazing milestone. As of this week, they have raised more than $1 million in donations for organizations like Conservation International and water.org. And since making the world a better place is really important to us, if you sign up now at tabforacause.org/MinuteEarth2, you'll be in the running to receive a not-for-sale, limited-edition MinuteEarth tote bag. So head over to tabforacause.org/MinuteEarth2 and start doing some good.